we see each other, it ain't gonna be fun. So,
bro, that's gonna be a shootout.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, man. You gotta stay away from that.
Yeah, he's a bitch.
Yo, bro. Like our age, like listening to this, is this not crazy? And yo, my cousin's wilding out right now.
Dude.
So I'm fucking dead behind the wheel.
Let's go ahead and put a seat collar in place. Our slightly diminished left side, but
were you like hanging out with the right crowd and shit? Like there in high school, middle school, everything?
So middle school, that's where it all started. I was just like, I've always smoked weed in middle school, and like I was always like a fighter. I always like, I never let nobody talk shit to me, nobody disrespect me, nothing. So like around seventh grade, there was this girl. I ended up being with her for 6 years, and I fought this dude over her kinda. So I was beating this dude up. The teacher jumped on me. He started choking me. So I got up, I threw him against the locker. I was hitting him in the gut. He let go of me. I hit him in his face. There was blood everywhere. I beat him up. I fucking ended up telling him I was gonna kill him. So they had sent me to this. This is when everything started. They sent me to this. They sent me to this bad kid school. It was called Class Academy. So I started going there.
Class Academy is where they send kids from our area that can't function in regular schools.
Bro, I've seen schools like that. They literally beat kids.
Yeah, like, you can't behave enough in regular school, you get sent to Class Academy.
Yeah, and that's
so what, when you get to Class Academy, you know that you're around the worst of the worst in your area.
Yeah, for sure. It was always the worst.
You had like, I fought major kids
before that, so they were just sick of me, and me telling them I was going to kill their teacher, they wasn't having it. So they
well, he started it. He tried to break it up.
Yeah, all that shit, bro. Yeah. And so I got sent to that school. It was fun as hell there, and like there was cops there. I'd beat so many kids up there, I wouldn't take shit. And like it just like taught me so much shit. It made me so much worse, if that makes sense. It was like a little lockdown prison. They fucking pat you down before you go in. They make you walk through a metal detector, all that bullshit. And like I went to that school, so coming out, like I stopped going for like 6 months, and they ended up passing me for the last 6 months of school. I didn't go, and like because I wasn't fucking with them.
I didn't go really my senior year.
This is my seventh grade or eighth grade year, and I wasn't having
it. Oh shit!
Yeah. So I wasn't having
this
that.
This is all true. Like, then, this is all true. He's not making this shit up, dude.
And then, like, they passed me, so that's that. I started being real bad. I was smoking weed on the bus, doing all kinds of wild. They was always arresting me in there, always trying to tase me. I was always running from the cops. They would never tell me what to do. So that's when everything happened in my head, and I was just like, I started being real wild. I'd go to Walmart, people look at me wrong. I'm wanting to fight them. My girl has to calm me down all the time. I'm always trying to start shit. So that happens, and like I'm real wild now. That changed me completely.
Yeah. Like,
so I started hanging out with everybody wrong, starting getting into like selling all kinds of drugs, doing all kinds of bad shit, and like just hanging with the wrong crowd, playing with guns, doing all kinds of stupid shit. And so around 16, like 2 years after, I was selling perks, running back and forth to Detroit, grabbing perks. I felt like Superman, like nobody could stop me. My boy had his medical card up there, and we were just having a blast, put it that way. We were running it around here, just selling, making so much money. So I fell into the perks, and like that was my shit. And I was making the money, so I was like, why not keep doing it? So I was doing all kinds of wild. I was selling drugs every day.
Were you taking them too?
Yeah, every day. I stopped taking them for a while, and like I started getting really, real sick, and I was like, I'm not stopping. I'm just gonna keep taking them.
Yeah.
And they made me wilder. Like they made me not give a fuck even more.
It's crazy how it does that, bro.
Yeah.
Just takes over. Like Yeah. Everything.
His story is just like mine.
Just like mine too. Exactly, I swear to God.
Bro. Like it's all the same shit. Bro.
It takes over, and like I felt like I was the shit, running everything, making so much money, doing this, doing that.
It's our story, Eric.
All that, and like just selling everything I could to make money and keep doing perks. So I was doing whatever I could. I got my L's. I wrecked my first BMW.
Tell me about all the charges that led up to right now.
I want to hear about like your legal.
Ran from the cops. Like I had good luck with everything for real. I never got caught with nothing horrible until like, so I got off of perks. I started subbing it out. I was great. I was working for my dad. I got caught right back into, because my homeboy from Detroit, he was trying to fuck me over, and I ain't the one to fuck over. So this is when it fell out, and I had to find perks from everybody else. So he tried to fuck me over with pounds and pounds of weed and all kinds of shady shit he was doing to me.
Yeah.
Like, so I wasn't having it. So he went up to Detroit, and his girl trusted me, and that's where they fucked up. They let me in, and they fucked me over, so I wasn't having that. So I walked into a house with – I had two girls outside and another dude. So I walked in there, I bought a perk, I ripped that shit, I'm ready to go, right? I'm leaving, right? I fucking leave. They didn't come in. So I'm like, I forgot another, I'm gonna grab another perk. And they trusted me like that. So I let them all in, I punched the bitch in the face, and they all go on her, and I grab everything in there. I grab all the money, all the perks, everything. Running his shit. That bitch, the girls are handling now. I'm running the whole crib. So I get everything. I run in my truck, I get everybody in my truck. Nobody knows I have the perks, bro. Nobody knows I have 300 perks in my pocket. I ain't never told nobody. Nobody needs to know that. That's my shit. Fuck that.
And yo, my cousin's wilding out right now.
Dude, this shit's just like and fucking blowing my mind.
That girl said eventually that she seen me leaving with everybody because I played them so hard. So I get back to my house with everything. I'm so happy I got all these perks, bro. I'm so happy. They're like, you robbed me. I was like, nuh-uh. They put a gun in my head and shit too. They're like, we seen you leave. So I ended up going back to her house. And he's still not home. So I went back. She had more weed on the table. You know what I did?
Oh my god.
So after that,
you straight get to wild.
They knew it was me. Always did that wild shit. Like, adrenaline. So I did that. I left. And like that ended everything with that. All right. So I couldn't
find. Oh, yeah. You cannot go back after all that.
Yeah. So me and him, if we see each other, it ain't going to be fun. So,
bro, that's gonna be a shootout.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, you gotta stay away from that.
Yeah, he's a bitch.
Yo, bro. From like our age, like listening to this, is this not crazy? Like,
it's crazy, dog.
This open about shit.
Yeah.
But I would never say, like, if I was his age, I would be like, dude, I don't know. I don't do shit.
That's
bro.
How I was. So I fell out with him. Big fallout. You feel me? He fucked me over. He got it worse. So I don't play that.
Hey, so man. I fell off. A fucking perk. Eye for an eye, man. A tooth for a tooth.
Exactly. Give me that tooth. So I fell out with
that. Didn't lead to no charges.
No, I didn't know. Yeah, I've been smart with everything for real.
Like, what could they do in that situation anyway? You know
exactly,
what I mean?
You know, so I robbed him. I was still doing my wild shit, selling everything. I was making major bread, I was doing all kinds of shit. So my dad had bought this business and I started working. I started just taking subs, like, I was chill for that whole year, half a year maybe. And like I was doing perks, doing all kinds of shit. So around like November or something like that, I started like getting back into like Zans and perks and robbing people and doing all kinds of wild shit. Not giving a fuck who was around me, not giving a fuck about anybody who was there for me. And like all that shit, and like treating everybody around me like shit, you know? I was all drugged out, like just, I didn't give a fuck about nothing, just myself and money basically. Yeah. And getting fucked up, you know. I was driving around getting fucked up.
We didn't give a fuck who we hurt.
Exactly. I was stealing major money from businesses. My dad, major money. So like, I stole probably over 20,000, 30,000 from my dad. I took check coming here because he owns a business, and I was just taking them, cashing them, doing all, writing checks in my name. I was.
Oh, damn. Okay, yeah.
So, like, I didn't give a fuck who I hurt, nothing. I didn't care if I hurt my girl for 5 years at the time. She was my, she did everything for me, like, everything. So, I didn't give a fuck who I hurt. I was being mean to her, fucking my dad over, all that. So, December comes, I break my collarbone. I go right into the perks, fake perks.
How'd you break your collarbone?
I flipped the quad over.
Okay.
So, I broke what he broke on his collarbone, and,
scapula.
They didn't give me no pain meds, and I immediately after I was like, "This is too much. We're going right now,
bro." That's what they're doing with me.
They didn't give me no pain meds. I was like to my girl,
but
right
I'm
now,
just pretending like I'm in prison still. Like,
and she knew,
you know how it is. But you're in solitary, and they like don't do shit for you.
Dog, they just make
I'm
it.
I'm in
work.
That mental right now, and but yeah, knew. I broke my scapula. Just like yeah, he broke his scapula.
So I was like, I gotta go get perks, and they were fake. So I didn't know it at the time, but they got me overly fucked up, and I probably did know it at the time.
So fentanyl perks?
Yeah. So I had my girl. I was like, bro, I need them. Like, I need them. So she knows exactly what's about to happen, how I'm about to go right back into it. So I go right back into it. I'm perked out. This shit hurts. Just hurts like fuck. I'm so fucked up. I didn't give a fuck. I was just getting perked the fuck out, like, so I end up, my dad's like, you gotta go to rehab for these charges, and at the time, he didn't tell me he charged me with this felony 3 and all kinds of wild shit he charged me with. He didn't tell me this until I was about to get out of rehab. He's like, he charged me, and he's gonna drop the charges. So I get out.
My pops called the cops on me, too, so.
Oh, yeah. Don't even get into that, how many times they called me, 302'd me, I beat him up, I beat my brother up, all that shit. I didn't talk about that, but so that happened. I went to rehab. So I get out February 12th after my dad told me why the fuck he sent me there and how he charged me. And I wasn't, you know, like, fuck you, dude. You're my family and you're going to charge me.
That's even what I
robbed,
yeah.
Even though I robbed the shit out of him and not gave a fuck about it.
But still, it's because he loved you, bro. Yeah,
I look at it now. Yeah. But I get out February 12th. That night, I go to sleep fine. I'm with my girl. She came and got me with my dad. I'm cool. The next night, she stays with me all three of these days. She, like, you know, she's with me the whole time. I start freaking out. I'm like, I can't go to bed. Fuck this shit. I'm getting high. I go get Xanax. I start snapping. She can't handle me. So we wake up. It's fucking Valentine's Day. On Valentine's Day.
Were you blacking out on the Zans or just taking them out?
Always. I ate the fuck out of them.
Just blacking out.
Yeah.
That's crazy, bro, because that shit can get dangerous.
Yeah, bad. And February 14th, I woke up. My girl was sleeping. My dad was sleeping. I took the keys. I went to Giant
Eagle. Blacked out.
I was blacked out, yeah, for sure.
Fuck.
I went to Giant Eagle. Stole flowers, major. Stole all kinds of shit for Valentine's Day because I wanted to save my money for what I'm about to go do. I head to Beaver Falls, and I go buy some perks, some fake perks.
Oh, so
I get there.
Shit.
I buy the perks, okay? I crush one up, snort it. I'm on my way home. I don't even remember getting out of the parking lot, bro. So I'm driving. I black out. I don't know what the fuck happened after this. So I guess I'm driving. I hit a brand new car lot. Hit a brand new dealership, Chevy. Hit a car. Cops are following me. I overdose. So I'm fucking dead behind the wheel.
Let's go ahead and put a seat collar in place. Slowly diminish left side, but reactive.
I've been living fast. Feeling really bad. Time really moves fast. But hurry up and get in your bag. I'm with you, I'm not a fan. I know all these niggas getting mad. My hand on my trigger, I'ma die, respect, yeah. Fuck all my money, you get dog like that, yeah. I took too many pills, count up the bill.
All I'm trying to do now is fix my relationship that I want. Try to talk to her mom, maybe, I don't know.